There's actually quite a lot of data trying to understand the microenvironment in lymphoma to a greater degree. And we're learning that many different lymphomas have quite different microenvironments. And often the microenvironment is actually driven by the nature of the malignant cell. So the malignant cell may have mutations. These mutations may then cause a certain population of immune cells versus a different population of immune cells to be more prevalent within the microenvironment. And we've learned that many times the microenvironment over time, rather than targeting the malignant cell in an effective fashion, has actually become quite suppressed and overwhelmed and sometimes worn out with trying to respond, and now has this exhausted and suppressed immune phenotype. And the reason that matters is a lot of strategies for treating patients are utilizing this information to overcome those problems. And the ways in which that's happening, number one is just forcibly taking T cells or other immune cells and sticking them to the cancer cell. And that's happening very much with treatments like bispecific antibodies. Or alternatively, engineering those T cells and infusing them so that they will automatically stick to the cancer cell. And that's CAR T cells. But then there are actually now a number of immune checkpoint blocking antibodies, which are taking away the messages that are making these cells exhausted. And we're seeing new ones of those now kind of coming to the fore, targeting them beyond PD-1 to starting to target other immune checkpoints. And that's proving very interesting and encouraging. And then the final thing is, many times there are macrophages and monocytes, and many of them are part of the problem. You can change the cell by taking away don't eat me signals and other signals that the tumor cell is providing. You can engage that part too. So we're seeing now a variety of different strategies being taken to heart and being used to effectively target the tumor cell. But I think the future, however, is going to be combinations of these. And I would even say that I think old-fashioned chemotherapy may still have a role, because, as I mentioned earlier, the tumor cell drives this whole thing. So you need to target the tumor cell and then augment the microenvironment. And these are some of the things that are being explored.